Hi, this is I'm Joe Shelley, and this is my second testimony on how God has worked in my life. And this one's going to be about my marriage, mainly about my marriage. All right, so for my last video, I was into drugs, alcohol, sex. I got this girl pregnant. Who I knew, a friend who I knew about 4 years before we started having sex. And well, she got pregnant. And when she told me, I was like, well, what do you want to do? She wanted to have the baby, and I knew I was in no shape, and that's when I, got on my hands and knees for the first time on my own before God in like 8 years. I asked him, I need a change, stop my drugs, my smoking, my alcohol, which I cut down a lot of my alcohol, but I didn't stop completely. Sorry, I got really bad allergies today. But help me change, help me to be a father that would be pleasing to him, and that was my prayer. I just laid it on the floor, and I believe he's been, answering that ever since. Well, we got married, and I guess it was about, I would say about 2 or 3 months into it, I started seeing a different side of her. She, cussed me out for the first time, and it was like the first time she cussed me out, I was like, wait, where's Nancy? But after that, started doing it more often, and then after 2 or 3 months after that, I got used to it, thinking, hey, I gotta take the bad with the good. And I don't want to make her out to be the monster or anything. But we did have her good times. And I really enjoyed those. And well, then she started threatening divorce. This was like 6 months into the marriage. And it came to a point where I was like, all right, let's get a divorce. You know what? You keep on threatening me. Let's get a divorce. Where do I sign? And then after that, she pretty much quit threatening me. Because, marriage is about the vows are, through richer or poorer, sicker in health, and we're supposed to be together. God put us together, let man not separate. And we're all in this, and me and her are in this together, But it was a lot of, I was trying to live up to her standards, and I just couldn't meet that at all. I couldn't do that. I couldn't live in her view of what her view of a husband should be, and I couldn't do it. And well, it went on. I guess it was, 14 years in the marriage. Well, during the 14 years of the marriage, that was the point of breaking point for me. I became, depressed in that. But I'm gonna talk about during that road of 14 years. I remember the job I was at when we first got married. It was about 30 minutes, trip there and back. But where we were staying at, there was a dealer right behind us. I mean, right behind our back door, really, our back window. We didn't have a back door. It was an apartment, and she said one day, wouldn't it be nice if you could get a job there? And I'm like, yeah. But you know what I did? As I prayed for it, I prayed that a job opportunity would come up there, and I could get a job there. And it was like 2 weeks later, she was looking in the paper and she saw, a wanted sign or wanted, ad. Right there, she goes, "Hey Joe, there's a job opening over there." And I said, "All right, And I knew in my heart that that job was mine. I just knew from God, put it in my heart that it was mine. And I waited like a day or two, put an application in, and I put an application in. Like 2 interviews later, I had a job there. That job was cool at first, the first month. After the first month, it all went downhill for 4 years. Downhill. I mean, the way they treated you were treated like dirt. And it got to where I was being bombarded negatively from work and from, at home. And but I just kept on praying and kept on praying. And I remember one time it was so bad, I prayed. I said, God, I need some encouragement. And I'll never forget this day. And like the next day after that prayer, my old youth minister stopped by my work where I was working and just stopped by to see how I was. And he goes, how are you? I said, you just don't know how glad I'm here, you're here, that I can see it. And I just gave him a great big hug. And it was just God answered my prayer. And that's so encouragement. Oh, type of stuff I was going through at the time. But as time went on, we end up getting, yeah. We end up looking for a house after 2 years in our marriage, and I remember praying that, to find a house that, that we could afford, plus mainly a good area that we can raise a family. And I knew years later on down, there was a news. Thing that she read to me in the on our city, how our city was voted number one in Missouri to raise a family. And this was years later. And I was like, yes, that's another prayer that was answered. At that time, marriage was, shaky. And the other thing was, at that time, I came to a point where in my marriage that I was giving up. And I specifically remember a prayer. I would go outside every night, when it's nice out, the moon and stars and gaze through them and pray, And I remember she upset me, and I came out and I said, God, I am done with this marriage. This is my prayer. I was like, God, I am done trying with this marriage. I can't make her happy. And she's making me miserable. And I can't do it. I'm done. I give up. I want a divorce. And I know you hate divorce. And this is my prayer to God. I was like, I know you hate divorce. I can't take it anymore, But it wasn't but maybe about three or 4 weeks later, she started going through a medical, a health issue. And it's the same health issue as she did about 2.5 years earlier. And I said, God, you know what, God? I'm gonna sit back and I'm just gonna, be here if she needs me, but I'm not gonna try and make our marriage. I'm done. I had such resentment in me towards her and bitterness that I didn't want to deal with it anymore. I wanted to cut it off. And well, I saw her go through this, and she asked me to, attend with her some stuff, and I did. And I tell you, it was, I was just there for her. I wasn't there, to really help our marriage. I was just there for her, and that was it, But after that, it seemed like she gotten better, like she really changed. And I noticed that. I think the rest of the family knew noticed that too. And I said, hey, God, thank you, and kept on praying. I was like, God, you know what? I need to change myself now. I need to get this bitterness. I asked him. I said, hey, help me get this bitterness, this resentment out of me, so that I can love again. And he done that. 'Cause about 2 years later, after this medical thing and this health issue, she came home one night. I remember this. This is the big story, of this video. She came home one night with a little note, and she was telling me there's like an encouragement wall by her work, and people write notes, and just roll them up in little scrolls and throw them in the little container, and those that just stop or walk by can just grab one and take and read it and say, oh, that's cool, but she brought this home, and she was all smiles, and I knew something was going on. And she goes, yeah, I got this note, and she told me how it worked, where she got it from. And she goes, read it. And I read it. And when I first read it, the first words was, let go and let God. And I was like, oh, okay. And then I started reading it, reading it, and reading it, and reading it. And I was like, oh my gosh, no way. I wish I had the note now, but I don't. But I have it here on my cell phone. Just a second here. I gotta find it. Sorry it's taking so long. Hopefully I can edit this out. Oh, here it is. Okay, it says, let go and let God. No matter how many times you get knocked down, keep getting back up. God sees your resolve. He sees your determination. And when you do everything you can do, that's when God will step in and do what you cannot do or you can't do. Now, when I read that, I was like, oh my goodness. And then I saw who wrote it. And I tears came in my eyes, 'cause it was kind of a personal message from God. And hope you can see this. I took a picture of it. Well, that is the note. It's on the refrigerator. It's been there for years now. But that was a note. Oh, pff, sorry. This is the note that was, it's still on my refrigerator to this day, years later. I'll probably never throw it away, but it was written by Joel Osteen. And I wasn't excited that it was written by Joel Osteen at all. I was amazed on what the message was, because the message was to me. And that, after I read that, I sat her down. And I said, hey, can I tell you something without you getting angry or upset, but it's good. And I sat her down and I said, look, you know what? First of all, I asked her, I said, hey, can you honestly say that our marriage is better now, has been better for the last, year, year and a half now? And she goes, yeah. I said, well, I'm going to let you know that I gave up on our marriage, a couple of years. I put out a prayer to God. I said, God, I'm done with this marriage, and I went out, I wanted a divorce, and I told her this, and this was between me and God. I was telling her the prayer, and I said, I couldn't make you happy, and you were making me miserable, and but I'm glad now that this came about, because this is like a personal message from God saying, hey, let me do the work. I know you want resolve, but put it in my hands next time. And I almost cried. I started tearing up, because like I am now, and it was a very touching moment. But our marriage has gotten way better after that, and I can't thank God enough. It is, and marriage is, it's a journey. It's a journey of togetherness. And, well, that's pretty much all I have. That's it. Thank you for listening. I'm going to put another video out on the next chapter of my life right now, what I'm going through. I'm actually going to try and do some of it live. Not live, but it, God's handling it, and I'm doing what I can to resolve it. But He's going to ultimately do the healing and all that in this next chapter of mine. It's going to be what I'm doing, what I'm doing to be better. But I think it'll be good, and in the end result, I hope it's good. It's going to be good either way. But until then, thank you for watching. This is Joe Shelley, my second testimony of how God has worked in my marriage, how He's answered so many prayers that, just really answered so many prayers that encouraged me to continue to walk in seeking Him, finding Him. And it's a blessing. Thank you. I thank God for that. I thank you, Lord. And have a nice day. Be blessed and be the blessing. Thanks. Bye.